Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. First of all, a very happy Makara Sankranti to you all. And in this video, I'm going to share a small book I created for my son to explain what is Makara Sankranti and what do we all do and how do we celebrate this festival. So further ado, let's get started. What is Makara Sankranti? It is an ancient Hindu festival that is celebrated on 14th or 15th of January every year. On this day, the sun transits to the zodiac sign Makara, which is Capricorn. So this day marks the end of winter and the beginning of spring. From this day, the nights become shorter and the days get longer. It is also called as the harvest festival, and farmers get together to thank sun, soil and cattle that help them for the good harvest. Different parts of the country celebrates this festival differently and calls it with different names. Pongal, Bihu, Lohri, these are some of the names. Distributing rice, sweets and other food items to the needy and donating these things to the needy is also an important part of the festival. 4 days of Sankranti. The Sankranti is celebrated for 4 days. One, Bhogi Sankranti, which is also called Pedda Pandaga. I am talking about Andhra rituals more in this video. And Kanuma, Mukkanuma. Bhogi. It is the first day of Sankranti. Bonfire is lit on the early hours with logs of wood, palm leaves and old furniture that are not in use. It is a sign of change by discarding old things and concentrate on new beginnings. All the family members take oil bath and dress up. People clean their houses in the event of Pedda Panduga, which follows. Many traditional foods like arisalu, laddus, chakkalu are made days before the festival. Sankranti, also called as Pedda Panduga in Andhra. This is the main day of the festival and hence it is called Pedda Panduga. Entrance of the houses are decorated with beautiful rangolis, muggus. All the family members wear new clothes and pray God. On this day, a dish made with rice, milk and jaggery called sweet pongal is offered to God. It is a tradition to remember ancestors by offering new clothes to them. Kanuma. Kanuma is the third day of this festival. This day is very close to farmers. It is the day for thanking and showing the love towards cattle, especially cows. On this day, farmers clean their cows and decorate their horns with colors. Mukkanuma. It is the last day of the festival. It is the day for elaborated feast and visiting friends and relatives. The tradition of flying kites is followed all over the country. Gobbemalu, made with cow dung and used it to decorate the muggus, are immersed in the river on this day. That's it guys, thank you so much. This is a small book I created for my kids to teach them about our festival, Sankranti, and how we celebrate it. Other than this, we talked about how we celebrated when we were kids and all the stories about our childhood celebrations on Sankranti holidays. So yeah, I think this is the way we pass our traditions and our festival to our kids, right? So I hope you like this and thank you so much for watching again. And I wish you all a happy Sankranti and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.